See, the refraction wants to take place means what we need? We need a lenses. What are the types of lenses we are having? Then afterwards we'll derive the refraction formula. Okay, types of lenses. Types of lenses. What are the types of lenses we are having? Okay, already we discussed in the previous classes, we are having the convex lens and concave lens, double convex lens, plano convex lens, convex, concave or concave, convex. Okay, now we'll draw the diagrams one by one. There are many types of lenses are there. Only I am going to draw only few. So if you want to get the lens, definitely the two surfaces will be exist. So here this is the first surface. Let us take this is the curvature. So this also one curvature, and then another curvature is there. So then this is R2. Let us take this is allosphere. Again another allosphere is there. Okay, if you rub this side, what are you getting in between? Same thing you are getting. So that's why this is the R1, this is the R2. Like that. This we are calling double. See how many curves are there here? Two curves are there. That's why double convex. Similarly, we can draw opposite to this one, double concave. Oh, we can draw this one. Double. Okay, this mirror name is double concave. This is double convex, this is double concave. Same thing here. This is also R1, this is also R2. Next. Okay, see, this side is plane is there. This side is what is there? Curve shape is there. What we can say this is? Plano. See, if it is like this, rays are coming like this means, this what we can say that is plano convex. Convex. Then what we can say this is? Plano. Plano concave. Then plano convex also may be there like this. See, lens means two sides should be transparent. Okay, if you consider this, what we can say this is concave. If you consider this side, what we can say that is convex. What we can say? Plano, concave, convex. Like this, there are many types of lenses we are having. Okay, in our syllabus, most of the cases we are using the double convex or double concave we are using. Okay. Now, till now we discuss about the types of lenses. Okay, the refraction takes place, what I said, it is refraction wants to take place means reflection should be there. Refraction wants to take place means what we need? Lens we need. Okay, that refraction happen in the surface or curved surfaces or surface. How that is happening? Or relation between U, V and R relation. Now what is the relation between U, V and R? That where we are going to discuss refraction in the topic. Okay, for that what I consider here? Spherical surface. This is one surface. This is principal axis. See what I said here, two mediums are there, medium 1 and medium 2. This is the first medium, this is the second medium. Okay, now I am thinking this is rarer medium. This is the denser medium. That I am taking here, this one, N1. This I am taking here, N2. Medium 1, medium 2, or N1 and N2 also you can take. Now I am considering on the principal axis. This is the principal axis. This is the, now let us take, this is the lens. Okay, this is the center of lens. Then in the mirror, what we are calling that is optical pole we are calling. Here at this point, we are calling the center of the lens. Rarer, denser. Okay, the ray is going like this. Okay, this also having C point. Okay, here object is there, point O. So the ray started from the object. It is striking at on the surface, on the lens, at A point. At this point, what happened? It is coming back, or it is passing through this surface. It is passing through the surface. Why? Because this is a refraction. This is not coated. Actually, it has to go like this, but it can't go like this. Slightly bent. Instead of going like this, what happened? Slightly bent, and it is traveling like this. It is reached there. What is this object? Then what you are getting here at this point? Image you are getting. That is I. So where is the normal line? I said, where this ray, incident ray this is. Which ray this is? Incident ray. This is refracted ray. Why? Because this is not reflection. This is refraction. That's why this is refracted ray. Refracted ray. This is incident ray. Incident ray, next one refracted ray. Okay, where is the normal line? Okay, where this ray is ending, where this ray is starting, at that point you have to draw one perpendicular line. The perpendicular line definitely pass through the center of curvature. Definitely it pass through the center of curvature. See, this normal line and this incident ray, these two are making some angle or not? Yes, those two are making some angle. Third, we have to consider theta 1. Again, this side also you have to consider theta 2. Understood? This point we can say P point you can take. So, center of the curve, center of the lens. So, this is theta 1, this is theta 2. Now, see, this ray and this ray making some angle or not? Yes, these two are making some angle. Again, this and this normal line and this line also some making some angle. Yes, this ray and this line also making some angle or not? Yes, that. Okay, let us take, you can consider any angle here. This we can take alpha, this you can take beta, this you can take gamma. So if you observe here, there are triangles are there. See, A, O, C, one triangle is there. Next one, next triangle, where is the next triangle? See, A, C, I, these two triangles are there.